Before we get into the details of the Q800A, let's take a quick look at Samsung's 2021 Q-series soundbar lineup. On the top left, you can see we have the Q600A. Comes with a 3.1.2 channel setup. And this is not true Dolby Atmos as it supports only ARC and does not have the eARC. There is also no built-in voice assistant in this model. Now we move to the model under review here, which is Q800A. The eARC starts from here, which means you get the true Dolby Atmos on this model. And from this model onwards, you also get the built-in voice assistant. And this is again a 3.1.2 channel setup. Now moving ahead next, you have the Q900A, which is a 7.1.2 channel setup. And again, comes with eARC, voice assistant and so on. And the flagship is the Q950A, which is 11.1.4 channel setup. And has all the features and beyond and is the flagship model for 2021. So with this insight, let's now get into the unboxing of the Q800A. Alright, now let's get straight away to business and look at the physical overview of the soundbar. This is the Samsung logo engraved on the soundbar. The build quality is good. It's got a nice metal finish on it. Some physical buttons, the volume plus, minus and so on. Now let's move it to the side. This is how thick it is when looked from the sides. And let's also fully invert it. As you can see, there are some vents for air circulation. And let's look at the naming. So that's the model code 800AQ800A, and it's made in Vietnam. And the first set of ports, there's an optical in port, a USB port which is for service, and the DC 19 volt power input socket. And moving further to the right, we see the HDMI ports. There are two HDMI ports. One is the regular HDMI port and the other one is the eARC or the ARC port, which stands for the audio return channel. The soundbar itself is lightweight. It's about 3.6 kilos. And in terms of the length, it is about 38.5 inches or 98 centimeters. Now let's take a look at the subwoofer with the Samsung logo in the front. The subwoofer is heavier in comparison with the bar and weighs about 9 plus kilos. This is from the side, the fabric covering for the subwoofer. And from the rear. So that's the power input and the subwoofer model. Next, coming to the topic of pricing, the online prices are higher than the offline prices in stores such as Chroma or Girias. One can pick this setup for less than 40,000 rupees. Next, let's take a look at what comes inside the box. This is the HDMI cable that is provided with the soundbar. This is the cable for the subwoofer. So the pin shown now goes into the rear of the subwoofer, and the 2-pin plug goes into the AC power port. Next, we have the plug, the power cable for the soundbar itself. This requires an additional converter brick, so that small pin goes into the soundbar and the 2-pin plug goes to the AC port. And this is the additional AC to DC converter brick. And we can briefly see the specification. It's rated for 100 to 240 volts of operation. Next, let's remote that is provided with the soundbar. This is the remote. Here we have a power button. Then we have two separate buttons, one for the main soundbar volume control and then the other one for the woofer volume control. There's also a mute button here, and then we have the surround modes. There are actually four surround modes that come with the surround the soundbar, which includes an adaptive mode, a standard mode, which is typically stereo, then a surround mode, and lastly the game mode. This is also a settings button. There's also a button for pairing, using which you could pair your phone with the soundbar for Bluetooth playback. Okay, now we have the Samsung Q800A connected to the TV and switched on. The connection is via the ARC, HDMI ARC connection. First of all, let us explore the Alexa features of the soundbar. Hey Alexa, what's the weather like today?
Right now in Bengaluru, Karnataka, it's 23 degrees Celsius with partly cloudy skies. Tonight's forecast is cloudy with a low of 15 degrees.
Next, I also paired the soundbar with the Samsung TV. And in case of the Samsung TV, the SmartThings app can be installed on the Tizen platform itself. And as you can see, the soundbar can be controlled from the SmartThings app, which has been installed on the TV itself. The next step was to configure the eARC mode on the TV, configured it to auto, and also enabled the Dolby Atmos compatibility so that it would get passed through to the soundbar. The next feature we look at is Q-Symphony. This is a feature where, when paired with a compatible Samsung TV, the soundbar and the TV speakers work to synchronize. The speakers on the TV also work together. There you can see that I am selecting the options and it shows TV plus soundbar. So this is the Q-Symphony feature on supported Samsung TVs. As the setup and configuration is now fully completed, I started to test the system. I tried various audio sources, which include YouTube, Amazon Prime Music, Netflix, Dolby Atmos demo content, and also movies such as Dune and Blade Runner 2049, which are known for their Atmos content. Netflix has an easy approach to searching Atmos content. One just needs to type Dolby Atmos in the Netflix search and it lists all the titles having Atmos. Another interesting aspect is that Netflix app also detects the soundbar to be Atmos compatible. So when the app is initially shown, it showed only 5.1, and when the soundbar is switched on and then you check the app again for the details, it now displays the Atmos logo also next to it. Despite Netflix showing the Atmos logo, the soundbar did not show it as Dolby Atmos. So it must have been compressed Atmos. So we finally tried with Dune and Blade Runner 2049. And in this case, the soundbar actually showed the Dolby Atmos in the scroll on the display of the soundbar itself. There you can see eARC now. And when we start playing the movie, there you can see the Dolby Atmos actually scrolling in the soundbar. So this is the true Atmos that we got it to work. Next, we take a look at the pros and cons of the soundbar, starting with the pros. The soundbar greatly experiences the TV viewing experience, comes with a compact form factor and easy to use and set up, supports the latest standards such as eARC and True Dolby Atmos. You can experience directional sound. It provides a room filling experience and great for smaller homes where space is a constraint. Next, let's take a look at the cons. So this system lacks rear speakers. Not only that, these rear speakers are not sold in India as a separate package. The sound is good, but not as intense as a full-fledged home theater system with floor standards and subwoofer. Q Symphony and few other features are available only with Samsung TVs. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. I now leave you with some royalty-free music content played using the soundbar.